And the Lord's Prayer says like this, Our Father, or my Father, who art within me. Where is heaven? It's not in the sky. There is a kind of heaven in the sky, but that's another story. It's not the heaven we understand. You don't want to be out there when you die, floating around there. So, my Father who art within me, you know, blessed, hallowed be thy name. You know, you, thy kingdom come. Thy will be done. Whoa. Because most of you are not under that. You're under the other spell. You're under the other influence, and it will keep you from, the spirit of other people will keep you from coming to that light, because it means they lose the control they had. Even the sense of worth you give them, which you don't even know you're giving them by liking them. I don't like you or dislike you. I mean, I see you're a nice person. I take you at your word until I see you're not a nice person, but that doesn't bother me either. And if you're not a nice person, I might tell you. I said, you know, how can you be both people? I had to go to see the other side first. Say, how can you be? Which one are you? And talk to you that way. So let me finish the Lord's Prayer and answer your question. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done. Not anybody else's will, because you see, we're caught up in a trap of thinking that the will that's in us, that we're born into, that it gets into us as we come into the world, is our will. At what it wants, we want. And what it thinks, we think it's our thought. Even the excuse is not our thought. It is given to you to defend the enemy within you and the enemy of the world that looks like your friends. See that? And so, well, the light is always there, but it's bothering because you're made up of that. Your psyche, you're built layers by layers by layers by conditioning, because it's hard to wake up a cannibal for being a cannibal. It would be, you know, he hasn't got enough life left where you could change him. It's too much a cannibal. There's a point of no return where a person is what he is, and that's, yeah. And so people can change in their look and their appearance and their health and everything for just one thing, a change of ownership, a change of allegiance. And all of a sudden, the flow comes differently and flows, washes out all your judgments. If you have a drug, then you've made the giver of that drug or the drug, the spirit behind it, a god. And therefore, you will never recover, ever. Forgiveness cannot be obtained by a pill.
Right, so don't take it.
You know, but I didn't say you shouldn't take it. That's why I'm not saying that, because I don't want it to be my will, or even God's will, as an instruction. You have to see that for yourself. Is it true that forgiveness of your sins cannot come from a pill?
Well, I think
is it logical?
Mm-hmm. I think what I can, what I'm going to try to do is not take it and just
suffer.
If I lie down on the floor with my feet up and rest, my hands up and just rest for about 10 or 15 minutes, I feel very different afterwards.
If that works, if that is the rituals are commitments. They transition you from one place to another. For instance, the ritual of marriage.
Well, and it's just complete relaxation. It's complete relaxation and meditation, because I'm also meditating at the same time.
But I limit the rituals to as little as possible. I don't even go as far as baptism, because Jesus says, John says, I baptize you with water, but the one who comes after me will baptize you with the Holy Spirit. So what am I doing with water? It's symbolic, but it is a ritual of conversion. I mean, it takes you a part of the way. See, it's neat. But point is, I can take you the whole way now, just by showing you how simple everything is. There's nothing for you to do. In other words, it's only allowing the light to come in to look at your foibles and weakness, and you're looking at unforgiveness. And if you take a pill, then your belief is wrongly directed. And that is what's wrong with everybody in the world, where their belief is wrongly directed.